new time when there will be a new heaven and a new earth, and God's people will be with God for eternity. God uses light in amazing ways throughout God's grand story. As we reflect on the birth and life of Jesus Christ, let us consider how light and darkness play into God's mighty works. God creates light.
Genesis 1. In the beginning, when God created the heaven and the earth was a formless void, and darkness covered the face of the deep, while a wind from God swept over the face of the waters. Then God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. And God saw that the light was good, and God separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and the darkness night. And then there was evening, and then there was morning, the first day.
Once upon a time, the universe was hidden in darkness. There were no stars to shine at night, no sun to rise or set, and no moon to reflect light to the earth. In fact, light didn't even exist. But God did the impossible. God brought light out of darkness. Can you imagine? One moment there was no such thing, and then God speaks. And with God's words, God separates the light from the darkness. From the first pages of the Bible to the very last, light is an important theme. Tonight, as we trace the theme of light from Genesis to Revelations, we worship Jesus, the light of the world, born to deliver us from darkness.
Please enjoy our song of Revelation. Reflection, sorry. Silent night, holy night.
Could not enter the house of the Lord because the glory of the Lord filled the Lord's house.
them as light. Each day, the light of God led the people as they traveled from Egypt to Canaan. When God moved from the tabernacle into the temple, the light of God's glory was so bright and glorious that people couldn't even look at God. Many years later, then Jesus was born on a dark night in Bethlehem. The bright light of the angels shone down on the shepherds, and once again, the light of God's presence was so glorious that the shepherds were terrified.
Please enjoy our song of reflection, The First Noel.
Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord has risen upon you. For darkness shall cover the earth, and thick darkness the peoples. But the Lord will arise upon you, and his glory will appear over you. Nations shall come to your light, and kings to the brightness of your dawn. The sun shall no longer be your light by day, nor for the brightness shall the moon give light to you by night. But the Lord will be your everlasting light, and your God will be your glory. Your sun shall no more go down, or your moon withdraw itself, for the Lord will be your everlasting light, and your days of mourning shall be ended.
In the Bible, walking in the light means living obediently to God. To walk in darkness means to walk apart from God. The Bible says that since Adam and Eve first sinned, the world has once again been covered in darkness. Even so, God promised to send God's light into the world, and God's plan was to shine God's light to all of the nations of the world.
Please enjoy our song of reflection, Mary, Did You Know?
Did you know? comes as the light.
Now we've seen three ways that light and darkness are part of God's story and God's mighty works. In creating the world, God also creates light. Then we learn that God is light, and as the light, God sends God's light to the nations. But God is not finished. In the fullness of time, Jesus came as the light. God creates light. God is light. God sends God's light to the nations. Jesus comes as the light of all people.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was light, and the light was the light of all people.
Jesus spoke to them, saying, I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will never walk in darkness, but will have the light of life.
Jesus is the true light of the world, and he entered into darkness of our sinful and broken world. The Christmas story is full of light, from the light of the angels who appeared to the shepherds, to the light of the star of the Magi followed in order to find Jesus. At Christmas, we worship Jesus as the light who shines in the darkness and gives light to all nations.
Please enjoy our song of reflection.
O come all ye faithful.
This is the judgment, that the light has come into the world, and the people love darkness rather than light because their deeds were evil. For all who do evil hate the light and do not come to the light, so that their deeds may not be exposed. But those who do what is true come to the light, so that it may be clearly seen that their deeds have been done in God.
Sadly, even though Jesus came bringing the beautiful light of God's presence, our hearts reflect the light that God has brought. Instead, we prefer the darkness. We would rather decide for ourselves what is right and wrong. We put our own wants above our neighbors. We say things that hurt others. We think and act selfishly. We prefer the darkness, yet even in the darkness, we long for the comfort of the light.
Please enjoy our song of reflection of the Father's love begotten.
Jesus endured the deepest darkness so that we might know the light of God's presence. He triumphed over the darkness so that the curse of sin might be defeated.
Please enjoy our song of reflection, Joy to the World.
God creates light. God is light, and God sends God's light to the nations. Jesus comes as the light of all people. We prefer the darkness. Jesus descends into the darkness. God shines God's light upon us. Might in turn shine God's light to the world. Jesus tells us that we are the light of the world, and we are to be known, make known God's goodness to everyone we meet. May God help us each day to be the light in a dark world.
Please enjoy our song of response, Go Tell It at the Mountain.
Jesus, lay down these
salutary that we should at all times and in all places offer thanks and praise to you, O Lord, Holy Father, through Christ our Lord. In wonder and mystery of the Word made flesh, you have opened the eyes of faith to a new and radiant vision of your glory. That beholding the God made visible, we may be drawn to the love of the God of God to whom we cannot see. And so, with the church on earth and the host in heaven, we praise your name. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it to all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for all, for forgiveness of sins. Do this in remembrance of me." And together we pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. At this time, for those of you who have not worshipped with us previously, you received your individual communion cups when you came in. There is a thin cellophane on the top where you can peel back to expose your wafer. And then your foil beneath that is your juice. The body of Christ given for you, and the blood of Christ shed for you.
Revelation 21.
And I saw a new heaven and a new earth. For the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. And I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. I saw no temple in the city, for its temple is the Lord God, the Almighty, and the Lamb. And the city has no need of sun or moon to shine on it, for the glory of its God is light, and its lamp is the Lamb. The nations will walk by its light, and the kings of earth will bring their glory onto it. Its gate will never be shut by day, and there will be no night there.
One day, night will be no more. The darkness of our sad and broken world will be forever done away with. In place of darkness, we will enjoy the radiance of God's presence for the rest of time. Until that day, we live in hope. Light has triumphed over darkness, and we leave this place tonight as those who've experienced the light of God's presence, and we are sent out as those who are the light of the world. Tonight, we will receive the light of the world, and we will watch it spread. We share it with others, and we will live in its warmth and its glow. So the way that we are going to do it is Quinn and I and Gavin and Zoe will come to the end of your pews, and we will light, we will come with our candle to light yours. We will hold ours straight, and you'll come in from the side as we enjoy our song. Now go in peace and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.